Hello everyone, this is Payal Bacha. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will discuss about quality risk management, that is a part 1. So let's get started. These are the list of contents we will discuss in this video. First one is introduction, next one is scope, principles, quality risk management process, risk management methodology, annexure 1 and annexure 2. In annexure 1, risk management methods and tools, and second one is integration of QRM, that means quality risk management, into industry and regulatory operations. Annexure 2, in this, potential application for quality risk management. Introduction. Risk is defined as the combination of probability of occurrence of harm and the severity of that harm. So first of all, what is risk in quality risk management? What is risk? So risk, it is defined as combination of two probability. First one is occurrence of harm and second one is severity of that harm, that are called as risk. So risk, that is a combination of two probability, occurrence of harm and severity of that harm. Second one is, what is management? Management functions include planning, organizing, staffing, leading or directing and controlling an organization, that is a group of one or more people or whole entities or effort for the purpose of accomplishing a goal. So what is management functions? Management functions, which includes planning, organizing various tasks, leading or directing, controlling organization. So controlling organization, what is organization? That is a group of one or more people or whole entity. Or management functions also include effort for the purpose of accomplishing a goal. So give the effort to accomplish or complete your goal, that all are management functions. Exactly. Quality risk management. First one, what is risk? Second one is, what is functions of management? And third one is, what is quality risk management? Quality risk management, it is a systematic process for the assessment, control, communication and review of risk to the quality of drug medicinal product across. That means quality risk management, that is a one type of systemic process, particularly for assessment of risk as well as control of risk and communication of risk and review of risk to quality of drug product across. So quality risk management, that is a one type of systemic process. First step is risk assessment. After risk assessment, second step is perform risk control. After performing risk control, perform risk communication. And last one is review of risk. Why all steps are performed? Risk assessment, risk control, risk communication and review of risk, all are performed to maintain quality of drug product. Process consisting of well-defined steps which, when taken in sequence, support better decision making by contributing to a greater insight into risk and their impacts. That means process that are consisting of well-defined steps. They are taken in sequence. So, all steps are taken turn by turn. First one is risk assessment. Second one is risk control. Next one is risk review. So, all are taken in a sequence that support better decision making. So, when all these steps are performed in sequence, turn by turn, so it gives the support regarding decision making by contributing to greater insight into a risk and their impact. So, all the steps, risk defining steps, all steps are performed in a sequence. So, it gives the better decision making. How it is possible? By contributing to a greater insight into risk, as well as it also gives the idea about effect on risk management or how maintain risk. It includes elements such as risk identification, risk assessment, mitigation, elimination, and communication. So, what is the risk process or world cycle? It includes various risk elements. First one is risk identification. First of all, risk is identified. After identify, risk assessment is done. After assessment of risk, mitigation is done. After mitigation, elimination of risk is required. And finally, communication with risk is required. Risk, that is probability and severity. So, what is risk? Risk is equal to probability and severity of harm that are called as risk. We discuss, already discussed, it include elements. Which type of elements are included? Risk, first of all, risk is identified. After identification, risk assessment is required. After that, risk mitigation is required. What is mitigation? Mitigation means action of reducing the severity or seriousness of something. Okay. After mitigation, risk elimination and risk communication is required. So, risk is probability and severity of harm. What is quality? The degree of excellence of something that are called as quality. ICH, International Conference on Harmonization, describe following guidelines for maintaining product quality, safety, and efficacy. So, first of all, what is quality? That is the degree of excellence of something. And ICH guidelines are present for maintain quality. First of all, what is ICH? ICH, that is an international conference on harmonization, that describe various guidelines for maintain product's quality, product safety, as well as product efficacy. First one, what is quality guideline? Quality, Q1 to Q12 guidelines that are available for quality maintain purpose. Next one is, what is safety guideline? Safety guideline, that is S1 to S11, S1 to S11 guidelines, which gives the idea about safety. What is efficacy? Efficacy means the ability to produce a desired or intended result that are called as efficacy. So, efficacy guideline, that is about E1 to E18. And last one is multidisciplinary guidelines, M1 to M10. So, various guidelines is present for quality, Q1 to Q12 guidelines, for safety, S1 to S11 guidelines, for efficacy, E1 to E18, And for multidisciplinary, M1 to M10 guideline is, guidelines are presence. Quality guideline. In quality guideline, first one is Q1A to Q1F. Q1A to F, that is useful for stability maintenance. Next one is Q2. In Q2, analytical validation is included. In Q3A to D, so Q3A to D, impurity guidelines is present. In Q4 to Q4B, all pharmacopoeias guidelines is available. Q5A to Q5E, quality of biotechnological products is present in quality guidelines. Next one is Q6A to Q6B, specifications is included in Q6A to Q6B. In Q7, good manufacturing practice is included. Q8, pharmaceutical development is present. Q9, quality risk management is included. And next one is Q10, pharmaceutical quality system is included. So stability, that is included in Q1A to Q1F. Analytical validation is included in Q2. Impurities guidelines included in Q3A to Q3D. Pharmacopeial guidelines included in Q4 to Q4B. Quality of biotechnological products related any guidelines included in Q5A to Q5E. Specifications included in Q6A to Q6B. Good manufacturing practice included in Q7, that means GMP. Pharmaceutical development included in Q8 guideline. Quality risk management included in Q9 guidelines. And last one is pharmaceutical quality system included in Q10. Q, it is indicated for quality guidelines. Next one is development and manufacture of drug substance, that is included in quality guideline number 11. Life cycle management included in Q12, quality number 12. Stability guidelines included in Q1A to Q1F, we already discussed. And last one is Q11, same. Development and manufacture of drug substances included in Q11 guideline. What is quality? Quality is a never-ending cycle of continuous improvement. So quality, it is the continuous improvement that are called as quality. It is the standard of something as measured against other things of similar kind, the degree of excellence of something. So quality, that is a never-ending cycle of continuous improvement. So continuously improved. Risk management. In risk management, first one is identify the risk. After identifying, risk is analyzed. After risk is analyzed, risk control is occur. After that, transfer is required. Risk reduction is required and risk assessment is required. That is the risk management steps. What is risk? We already discussed, risk means probability of something harm. Let's take one example. Warren Buffett said that never test the depth of river with both feet. That are called as one type of risk. So what is risk? We can't test the depth of river with or by using both the feet that are called as risk. Scope. What are the scope of risk management? These guidelines provides principles and example of tools for quality risk management that can be applied to different aspects of pharmaceutical quality. Drug substances, drug medicinal products, biological and biotechnological products. So what are the scopes? These guidelines which provide principles and examples of tools, particularly these guidelines which provide the principle and example of tools regarding quality research, quality risk management that can be applied to different aspects of pharmaceutical quality. So this guideline which provide principle and they provide various examples of tools, particularly for quality risk management and quality risk management that can be applied to a different aspects to maintain pharmaceutical quality. Drug substances, drug products, biological and biotechnological products quality are maintained, including the sections and use of raw material, solvents, excipient, packaging and labeling material, components. So all the material, raw material, solvents, excipients, packaging and labeling material, components, at all the stage quality maintenance is required. Principle. What was the principle of quality risk management? First one is the evaluation of risk to quality should be based on scientific knowledge and ultimately linked to the protection of patient. So what was the principle? First one is evaluation of risk to quality. Evaluate the risk based on quality. Should be based on evaluation of risk for maintained quality. Should be based on scientific knowledge as well as they are ultimately linked to the protection of patient. So quality risk that is evaluated because that is the link to the protection of patient as well as scientific knowledge. Next one is the level of effort, formality and documentation of the quality risk management process should be commensurate with the level of risk. So the level of effort, formality and documentation of quality risk management process should be commensurate with level of risk. So why risk is evaluated? Risk is evaluated to maintain quality. Why quality is maintained? Because quality is ultimately linked to the protection of patient as well as scientific knowledge. Overview of typical quality risk management process. So quality risk management, that is a ICH quality 9 guideline. Various quality risk management tools are available. So what was the process? First step is initiate risk management process. So first of all, start risk management process. After starting, first step is risk assessment. In risk assessment, three steps is performed: risk identification, risk analysis and risk evaluation. So that is the whole cycle of quality risk management process. First step is initiate or start risk management process. After starting, Risk assessment is required. In risk assessment, three steps is performed. First one is risk is identified. After identification of risk, risk analysis is done. After risk analysis, risk evaluation is occur. After risk evaluation, next step is risk control. In risk control, two steps is performed, risk reduction as well as risk acceptance. So, in risk control, risk reduction, reduce the risk. After reduction, risk is acceptable. And if it is unacceptable at this stage, so further go to risk assessment stage. And if it is risk is acceptable, so go to the risk communication. In risk communication, first of all, communicate with risk. And next one is output of the risk management process is given. If output or result of risk management is given, review the risk, and if risk is accept, then it is acceptable and further risk communication is done. But if risks are not acceptable, further theta go to risk assessment step. So all are regarding to risk management system. First one is starting risk management process. After starting, risk assessment is performed. In risk assessment, three steps are required. First one is identify the risk. After identifying, risk analysis is required. And after analysis, risk evaluation is required. So after evaluation, risk control is performed. In risk control, two steps is performed, risk reduction as well as risk acceptance. If risk is reduced and it is unacceptable, so further go to the risk assessment. But risk is acceptable, go to risk communication, and result of risk management process. After result of risk management process, that is reviewed, after review, if risk is acceptable in risk review stage, so it is further go to the risk communication. But if it is not acceptable, further go to the risk assessment step. That is the ICH Q9 quality risk management process. General quality risk management process. First one is responsibility. Next one is initiating a quality risk management process. Next one is risk assessment, risk control, risk communication, and risk review. We will discuss one by one. All are the quality risk management process, general process. First one is responsibilities. Take responsibility for coordinating quality risk management across various functions and departments of their organization. So in responsibilities, according to name, take a responsibility for what? So take a responsibility for coordinating quality risk management across various functions as well as departments of their organizations. Assure that a quality risk management process is defined, developed, and reviewed, and that adequate resources are available. So take a responsibility for coordinating quality risk management across various functions and departments of their organization. Assures that a quality risk management process, it is well defined, developed as well as reviewed, and adequate adequate resources are available for defined, developed, and reviewed quality risk management. First one is initiating a risk management process. So in starting step, define the problem or risk question, including pertinent assumption, identifying the potential for risk. That means in starting off or initiating a quality risk management process, first step is define a process or risk, including assumption that identify potential for the risk. After defining a risk, assemble background information or data on the potential hazard, harm, or human health impact relevant to the risk assessment. So, after defining a problem based on assumption, assemble background information or any data on the potential hazards, harm, or human health that directly affect to the risk. Identify a leader and necessary resource, and specify a timelines, deliverables, and appropriate levels. The first one is define a problems or a risk based on assumption. After that, assemble a background information or data on the potential hazards relevant to risk assessment. After that, identify a leader and necessary resource. And last one is specify a timelines, deliverables, and at appropriate level. Next one is QRMP. What is QRMP? Quality Risk Management Protocols. So, in risk assessment, first one is risk identify. After risk identify, risk analysis is occur, risk evaluation is occur, and the risk for risk assessment purposes, three fundamental questions are often helpful. So, in risk assessment step, three steps are performed. Risk identification, after identify, risk analysis is occur. After risk analysis, risk evaluation is done. So, for the risk assessment purpose, three fundamental questions are helpful. First one is, what might go wrong? Second one is, what is the probability it will go wrong? And last one is, what are the consequences or severity of risk? So, first question is, what is going to wrong? Next one is, what are the probability it will go wrong? And next one is, what are the severity of risk? Next one is risk control. Risk control might focus on the following questions. Which type of questions? First one is the risk above acceptable level? That means risk are above acceptable level, or risk is present below acceptable level. Risk is acceptable or not. Next one is, what can be done to reduce or eliminate the risk? All are the fundamental questions for risk control. So, what can be done to reduce the risk? After that, what is the appropriate balance among benefits, risk, and resources? So, how balance is maintained between benefits, risk, and resources? Next one is, are a new risk introduced as a result of identified risk being controlled? That means, if a new risk is introduced, when result of identified risk that is controlled, all are under the risk control. Risk control might focus on the following questions. We already discussed, is the risk above acceptable level or not? What can be done to reduce or eliminate the risk? What is the appropriate balance among benefit, risk, and resources? Last one is, are a new risk introduced as a result of identified risk being controlled? QRMP. In QRMP, risk communication is the sharing of information about risk and risk management between the decision makers and others. So what is risk communication? So risk communication, that is the one type of sharing information. What type of sharing information? So it is the sharing information about risk and risk management between decision makers as well as others. What is risk review? Last step. Risk management should be an ongoing part of the quality management process and a mechanism to review or monitor events should be implemented. That means in risk review, risk management should be ongoing part of quality management process. So for quality management process, risk management should be ongoing. And a mechanism to review or monitor this type of risk management event that are called as risk review. For any query or doubts related to topic, please write your questions in comment box. Thank you.